The opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of Eastlink TV, its sponsors, or partners.
It's a little intimidating being inside of this jaw, but this is the largest shark that ever lived. His name was Megalodon, and he was one big animal. He's an ancient ancestor of today's great white sharks that we find, but a lot larger. So exactly how big was Megalodon shark? Well, believe it or not, this shark was 16 meters long. And I know a lot of us are maybe afraid to swim in some of our oceans because of the great white shark that's out there, but this guy had a bite force that was 10 times that great white shark that we know today. So now, sharks are kind of neat. They're older fish, they have been around for millions of years, and they haven't really changed too much except maybe in size since that time period. This shark was by far the largest that ever roamed our oceans. They have some amazing teeth. Now, Megalodon though is kind of neat. We have lots of different teeth from Megalodon that we have found in our oceans, but we haven't found the rest of the Megalodon body. And there's a really good reason for that. Sharks are actually entirely made up of cartilage, and they have no bone. So just like the stuff that's in my nose, as an example, that would have made up the entire shark body. And so we don't find that cartilage because it eventually disintegrates, and only the really hard parts of body, like a tooth, as an example, would have been kept as a fossil. And we find a lot of them, actually, because sharks have an incredible ability to actually shed their teeth. Now, think about it this way. If you're a shark and you're ready to catch your predators and you want to eat something, you'll be tearing at the flesh of that animal, and they have these incredibly sharp teeth to do it with. So we see this row of teeth right here. This is the row that they're going to be eating with, tearing at that flesh. But right behind it, there are teeth actually all along this back row. And as the shark loses these teeth from tearing at the flesh, these teeth actually grow back in behind to replace the teeth that are lost. And so it's like a giant conveyor belt of that shark losing teeth and replacing teeth and losing those teeth again and replacing them with even more. And we actually find in the sediments of our ocean and in different fossil deposits all kinds of shark teeth from all over the world. And so these shark teeth here are fossilized shark teeth. They are teeth that were found in a huge fossil deposit, and they're quite little and probably belong to a whole bunch of different little sharks. But we find these shark teeth everywhere because not only the sheer number of sharks that we had living in our oceans, but also because they constantly are losing their teeth. So one of the cool things about sharks is they never needed dentures, which is really awesome. What an unbelievable and slightly terrifying animal.
Hey there, are you looking for a new friend? I bet you are, aren't you? Well, if you're looking for a new friend, why not tune to Eastlink TV Thursday nights after the newscast for Get a Pet. Puppies, kittens, guinea pigs, and hamsters, cuddly friends of all kinds are available for adoption from your local shelter, and we'll introduce you to them on Get a Pet, Thursday nights after the newscast, and only on Eastlink TV. Proudly sponsored by Ontario Mold Services.